Hello friends, in today's video we are going to discuss how to control the speed of this kind of DC fan with the help of the single MOSFET or an Arduino with a simple circuit design. Here I am Pratik Joshi with collaboration with the roboslog.in. Let's see which component we required. First we need an Arduino Uno. I am taking Arduino Uno. You can choose any other microcontroller as well. Second, we need a motor. Of course this motor is in your DC fan. Then to control it, we need a potentiometer to use as a controlling notch. Then we need a power control circuit. For this we need a MOSFET and diode. Here I am using n-channel MOSFET and high frequency Schottky diode, because we are controlling speed with the help of the pulse width modulation. Okay, now we need a optocoupler to isolate the high voltage and low voltage circuit. This is an optocoupler for isolation. Now we need a power supply, high voltage power supply for the motor. Here I am using 9 volt battery to drive the motor. You can't power this with the Arduino, because Arduino is just 5 volt and it can't deliver much current to run this motor. Here in your car or any backup battery, you can find 12 volt or 15 volt also. You can use it directly, okay, with this n-channel MOSFET. It is more preferable to use the IRF-Z44N MOSFET, because it have a high current capacity and it can handle up to a 60 volt drain to source. Now let's jump to the connection part. First we have to connect this input section with Arduino. In input section we have put here VCC, ground, and this is a variable pin which give us analog input as per the notch position. First connect the ground. I denote it with black color. Then we connect 5 volt, which I denote with a red color. Okay, we connect VCC and ground. Now this analog input output of the notch we connect with the analog input. Here in Arduino Uno we have an 80 to A5, total number of 6 input pin. You can connect it on any pin. Let's say take A1 as an input pin. Okay, now we need to give power to the motor through the battery. For it we use the MOSFET as a switch. Now let's zoom on MOSFET. Here we have three terminal: gate, drain and source. Gate is used for the controlling. In drain we connect the power supply side of the positive connection of the power supply we connect to the drain, and the positive terminal of the load, in our case motor, connect with the source. In on condition, current flow through drain to source. Okay, in off condition, current can't flow drain to source. Okay, now let's connect source to the motor terminal first. Now connect the drain to the battery power supply positive terminal. I denoted this positive voltage wire with a red color. Now connect the negative or ground terminal of the battery to the motor like this way. Now we can see why we use this diode. This diode is known as a freewheeling diode. The motor is an inductive load. So when this switch on and off with pulse width modulation, the motor current is tends to change, but the motor winding inductance is tried to make current constant. For this, during the turning off of the MOSFET, here the negative polarity high voltage is induced in the winding. This voltage may damage your MOSFET. To protect the MOSFET from damage, we use this freewheeling diode in reverse bias like this manner. Here you can see the MOSFET is in reverse bias. So diode is in reverse bias. So there is no current flow through the diode in on condition. But when turning off, here negative voltage induced. So the current is flow through this diode and provide the path to continuous current. So our MOSFET is protected against the negative high voltage jerks. Now we have to connect our optocoupler in next portion. We have to connect optocoupler. This is the circuit pin diagram of the optocoupler. Here LED and here photo transistor. These two are electrically isolated. So our high power and low power control circuit both are different from each other. For the sake of protection. Now here we connect the positive terminal, means our anode, anyone output pin from this digital pin. But here the problem is we want to control it with a PWM speed control method. So in Arduino Uno there is a 6 PWM pin. You can see here 3, 5, 6, 9, 10 and 11. These only pin are able to able to control the PWM signal. So we use this 6 pin for PWM control. I am using here pin number 11 to give control to this optocoupler and this motor driver circuit. Okay, now we have to connect the ground. Let's connect the ground. Here I am connect the cathode with the ground of the optocoupler. So optocoupler input side connection is over. Now we have to connect the output side. Here the collector, on collector pin we have to connect the VCC voltage, high voltage VCC, and at emitter we connect it with a gate terminal. First we connect the emitter with a gate terminal like this way. Okay, here I am getting signal showing with this blue color. Okay, now we have to give VC power supply to this optocoupler. So we connect this in this fashion. Here we connect this VCC high voltage means 9 volt with the optocoupler. So it seems our connection is finished. Okay, but there is a problem. This is MOSFET, means metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. This is a field effect, so not current flow here. Here only by electric field we control this. So problem is that when we turn on here, some electric charge is stored in the metal oxide layer. So when we turn off here, this charge is accumulated. It can't flow in any direction. So it will not properly turn off during the off time. So this not properly turn off. So we can't control the speed properly. To discharge this charge, we have to put one pull down resistor like this. This is a 10K resistor, and we have to connect it with between gate and source. So by this resistance we can discharge the gate. We discharge the electric charge which is present on a gate. Look this connection. Here we connect between the gate and source for the discharging this MOSFET. So by this method we can operate MOSFET on a very high frequency without any issue. This our connection is already fulfilled. Okay, connection is ready, almost ready. But we can use this connection for the our actual PCB design. But in some simulation softwares which I use, like a Tinkercad or a PCM, their algorithm can't support optocoupler as an gate drive circuit. So we can't use optocoupler as a gate drive circuit in simulation only. But in practical circuit we have to compulsory put this optocoupler to give protection to the microcontroller. Otherwise if damage MOSFET, leak the current, this high current can damage our Arduino also. But for sake of simulation we neglect this optocoupler right now. And I connect this gate terminal with directly with the pin number 11 and this black color with this black terminal which is ground, directly connected to the ground. This is for the only simulation purpose. Otherwise you have to put an optocoupler. Okay, now let's jump to the part simulation part, so you can see how circuit has actually work. Here in I have simulated this circuit in the Tinkercad. Let's start simulation. Okay, now motor is turning. If I put it on this notch on a zero. Okay, so this motor is on a zero RPM. If you can see, I zoom it. Look this. This is zero RPM. Okay. Now, if I increase the RPM slowly, this motor speed is increasing. This motor can capable to go on a 5000 RPM as well. If I increase the notch, you can just see this speed is increasing. Okay, look at this speed. This is nearly a 2000, around 2000 RPM. Now I am again increasing speed. Now this is nearly a 4000 RPM. I increasing again. This is nearly a 5000 RPM. Let do this speed full. This is around 5400 RPM speed. This is the highest speed of the motor. This is online simulation software, though you can't feel this running properly because graphics is not able to download that fast. But you can see this RPM. Now I reduce the speed on potentiometer. See my mouse arrow. I am reducing. This speed is also reducing. Look at that. Now we will directly jump to the zero. This is zero RPM. Okay, let's slightly increase speed, 400 RPM. Okay, now let's jump to the coding part. I have opened an Arduino IDE for the coding. Okay, Here only the this code is one of the easiest code I ever write in my life. Here only we have a four lines of code, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let me explain all the meaning of these lines. First we have a void setup and void loop. Two main functions are here. Void setup is only execute only a single time. Here we define the value which constant throughout the program. So we here declare the pin mode 11, means pin number 11 as an output mode. Here look at that, this comment shows that this is output declaration. Okay, this comment not executing the code, this only code is executing, and this pin mode is output. Here we have to only show digital pin we have to define only digital pin for input and output. We don't need to define output analog pin because Arduino Uno doesn't have any analog output pin. So by defaultly this pin is an only input mode. Okay, so we defined this as an output mode, pin number 11, which we have connected to optocoupler and MOSFET in the loop function. Here loop means this function is executing infinite time during the operation of the microcontroller or running time of the microcontroller. First we here read the pin A1, taking the input from the pin A1 where port is connected. Okay, so the input value of the A1 is read by this analog read function, and its value stored in the integer portval. Portval is an integer we defined here, and this value stored in this. Here analog read function read analog input and convert it into the 10 bit digital data. Okay, which store in the integer portval. But here our output function, which is an analog write, which is write on a pin number 11, the fan speed. Here we can't put this port value direct here, because the port well is in a 10 bit binary format, and analog write function only able to handle 8 bit. Okay, here 10 bit means 2 raised to 10, so 1024. If we start from 0, we get a highest value 1023, but in 8 bit we get 2 raised to 8, means starting from 0 to only 255 value are there. So we have to first convert this 10 bit data into the 8 bit. So we use here map function compare both from 0 to 1000 to 1024 and 0 to 255. So we read it, take port value from integer, and from 0 to 1023 convert it into 0 to 255, means scale down the value, scale the number from the port, and stored it in the second integer, which is known as a fan speed. And this fan speed has a 8-bit data, and this 8-bit data is executing is a value which used to control the fan speed here. Okay, so this only 4 line definition, reading, scale down to the 8-bit from 10-bit to 8-bit, and then analog write means pulse width modulation as per this fan speed data on a pin number 11. This pulse is applied as per the fan speed. Okay, this code is our finish, and this our simulation is also running perfect. You can see this. Okay, thanks for watching this video. Have any comment, have any doubt, please comment below. Thank you. If you need any description about this component used and the how to control and this program which I have executed here, you can all get from the website roboslog.in, or otherwise I put the link in a description of the video. Thank you.